Okay, we've had the budget. You've seen them there, looking like a bunch of. What's the word for it? Schoolboys. Jumped up, private educated, Uwe Henrys. Look at that Osborne. What a squealy, weedy little so and so he is. Oh, he's got mega millions or something. None of these classroom twits know what it's like to be at the bottom. They've never been at the bottom. They're all like mega bucks. And it's a Conservative Party, so when there's a deficit, who do they hit? They hit the poor. Hello, they're always a friend to the rich, Conservatives. Always hit them. Never hit the top, always hit the poor. Poor bash, poor bash, poor bash. So we've got all these pet projects, right? All this green, airy, fairy stuff. All being set aside, green, airy, fairy. Make windmills in Europe, I don't know. More dustbin vans come around than God. They don't pay for it, they don't make it give a toss. You pay for it. So all these are pet projects, you know, political pet projects. War, yeah. Tony Blair loves applause in America. Bastard, creeping nine little Satire and his mates, and they conned the Conservatives, so he's trying to say, oh, I wasn't conned, I was into this war, yeah, we really are pushing back the boundaries and keeping down the territories over there, which don't travel over here. But they've confused Taliban with Al-Qaeda, duh. Anyway, so that's more billions, mega billions, and lies, of course. And then you had the crunch. They say it's, they blame America, but they seem to get blamed sort of like BP sort of way. And so all the banks crunch. So they've underwritten all their banks, right? They've underwritten all the banks. Oh, they're very important. Yeah, to the paper at the top. And so they've been underwritten these Vegas banks. I think make them more big bad bucks. So you got that bloody, what's his name? Goodwin. Yes, thank you very much. Cold handshake. Goodbye. Megabucks. And Europe, another pet project. Labour one this time is communist. I want to be with the communist buddies in Europe and all that. Give them 6 billion plus each year. Prop the bloody crumbling mess up. And I'll, was it other Conservative coming? Said, oh, I'm not really, we're not really with the that Europe communist stuff much. I won't join the Euro. Oh, big deal. It's like collapsing, you twit. Now, so all these pet projects, wars, Europe, green, all that lot, banks, underwriting, all put aside and ring fenced, right? Who gets hit? Oh, Conservative, beat the poor up. So they're freezing all their money, they're kicking them off the bloody, off their disability, saying, look, you can do some work, you can be at this computer. What? And if you get a poor person, shove him under a computer and then you like, type his name, yeah, you're a computer operator. There's no actually jobs for typing your name, but if you can do that, they say, oh, there might be a job that you can, you know, you do something. And so all we've got to do now is prove you can do something. And your money gets halved. They halve it from incapacity benefit, halved down to job seekers. So they're kicking all these people off. There's about, I don't know, millions or something. And they're going to halve all their money, getting down on job seekers. There isn't millions of jobs available. There's just like about a few hundred thousand, which are like your temporary jobs anyway, minimum wage. Crop picking, not specifically going to be the top of your name. No, it'd be like crop picking, all that cheap, temporary, day here, day there, next week, seasonal, part-time gibberish malarkey. But not the millions of jobs available, anyway. So it's called job seekers. But it doesn't seem to bother them that there ain't that many jobs for the people to type your name in, anyway. So why have we got the expense of the war anyway? We've got the expense of the war because in America, they've ring-fenced all their green, airy, fairy, yeah, all the Conservatives, all the conservationists, I should say. Ah, ring-fence that, and don't drill oil, and don't drill oil. It's an American thing that says they've got about 300 years of war there, but no, you can't touch that. So that's how Blair has got into a war in abroad, because they're fighting to get more oil from America, because they're looking after their bloody green pastures. time. And the poor here are paying for that. And so Obama said now, this oil rig has got really bad stuff. No more drilling in the Gulf. I put an end to mega drilling. Deep drilling in the Gulf. It all ended because it's all bad, bad, bad. But he's got, he's loaning out his $2 billion to some company called Portobus in so Brazil can deep drill oil in their place. Yeah, yeah. Don't drill it there, it's all bad, deep drilling oil. But do it in Brazil. Brilliant. And he's also got his SO mob, yeah, it's all American mob, joined up with his Portobus mob, and they've gone off to Turkey to drill in the Black Sea over there as well. Deep